recently I've been dropping some videos, taking the first look at new shoes coming out in 2023 while I was at the running event. And, well, Nike was there, and I got to see a lot of interesting stuff, so we're going to dive into that today. So first up was the Pegasus 40. So last year, the Pegasus 39 got some big changes, so unfortunately that means that this year it seems to be just an upper change. It looks like it might use a more breathable mesh, but that's about it. It still uses the same midsole and outsole. I assume the price is going to stay at $130 as well, and the Pegasus usually comes out around April or May, so hopefully we don't have to wait too long for it to come out. Next up is the Nike ZoomX Invincible 3. So the Invincible 1 and 2 were very cushioned, but almost seemed too built up in a way. So luckily with version 3, they really stripped down the upper and chiseled away the midsole, so it seems to be more streamlined. The upper is a lot less bulky without that extra padding and uses a new Flyknit mesh. The midsole has a slightly higher stack height. It has a wider platform and has sculpted sides to help cut down a little bit of weight. The outsole is thicker and more durable this time around. So this shoe is $180 and it is out right now, so you can go to Running Warehouse and get yourself a pair. So the Vaporfly is one of Nike's most popular shoes, but it feels like it's been a while since it's got a big update. Luckily, that changes this year. So with the Vaporfly Next Percent 3, the upper is now a thin, open, and non-stretchy Flyknit material. The midsole now has a new blockier design with some cutouts in it. It is the same stack, but they decreased the rubber amount in the forefoot by 2 millimeters and replaced it with foam, so you technically get more foam underfoot. Like I mentioned, the outsole is now a little bit thinner, but it uses a new waffle-like pattern and is supposed to be just as durable. So this shoe will still be $250, so it's nice that it didn't get a price hike. And the prototype colorway is coming out very soon, I believe like March 6th or 7th, and then more colorways will be released after that. Next up is the ZoomX Ultrafly Trail, and this shoe reminds me a lot of if you mixed the Pegasus Trail with the Vaporfly, and it's almost like a Vaporfly of the trails. The upper uses Vaporweave material to help kind of keep water and debris out. The midfoot wrap is used to keep your foot nice and locked in, and there is light padding around the ankle. The midsole uses ZoomX wrapped in protective mesh. It is 36 millimeters in the heel and 26 in the forefoot. It does use a 3/4 length forked carbon plate that'll help give you some snap but not inhibit the lateral side-to-side movements. The outsole uses full coverage of sticky rubber, and it has some spaced out, not overly aggressive lugs. I would have to guess they're probably 3.5 millimeters. So this shoe will be $225 and it comes out this summer. I think the latest I've heard is July. So the very popular track spike, the Dragonfly, is now getting a cross-country version to help you tackle dirt, mud, grass, etc. So I don't know too much official info on it, but I did get hands-on with it, and I'll just kind of describe the changes I noticed. The upper is more durable than the track version, and it'll help keep dirt and water out. The back 3/4 seemed very similar to a Vaporweave material, with the forefoot being more of a mesh material. The midsole looks very similar to the track version, still ZoomX with a full-length PBAX plate that turns into the spike plate in the forefoot. The outsole slash spike plate has got a lot more grip than the track version and has Nike's aggressive cross-country style spikes to really dig into mud and grass. So like I said, I don't know the price of this. I'd have to assume somewhere in the ballpark of $160. I also don't know the release date, but I would guess sometime in the summer or fall, kind of around cross-country season. So this was a lot of exciting stuff, and that's not even all Nike has to offer this year. They've got a new Vomero coming out, a new structure, so lots of exciting stuff. But from everything I've shown, what are you most excited for? I know that the Vaporfly 3 and the Ultrafly Trail are definitely at the top of my list, and I'll probably pick up the ZoomX Invincible 3 soon to try that out, see how the changes are, and give you my thoughts on that. So go ahead and let me know in the comments down below if you want me to review the Invincible 3 and which shoe you're most excited for. Thanks for watching, and as always, keep on running. Thank you.